Be stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know each one, and they follow me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Lord, be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus arrived in Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him. But Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord. Pastor of Our Lady of Fatima parish here in Marysville, and as the parish priest of Peter Duffy, it is my duty to welcome you all here this morning, especially Peter's family and his friends. Peter and I have been friends for over 35 years. I'd like to write a book on Peter, and then some, but I'm not going today. Now, as you all know, Peter loved to talk. He loved to think. He loved to argue. Whether you agreed with him or not, he was going to tell you exactly where you stood and exactly what he thought. And at the end of the conversation, he would just say, "We better get over that." Peter and I, over the years, have had so many different and very deep conversations. There's not much that I don't know about Peter Duffy. Peter and I argue about many things, and of course he always thought he would win. And I always told Peter, and I used to stop in your shop a couple times a week, I said, "Peter, you know something? Someday I'm going to have the last say." I just didn't think last week that today would be the day. So I know this is difficult for all of you. I know it's very difficult for me this morning. But we come here to this parish church not to tell Peter's story and not to sing Peter's praises. You've done that since Saturday. You'll continue to do that after our funeral mass and in the days and months and years that lie ahead of us. We come here this morning as a people of faith because Peter Duffy was a man of faith, of deep faith. And he took his Catholic faith very, very, very seriously. And he would defend that faith, even to the death, if that was what it took. And so, in the midst of our mourning and our grieving for Peter, we come here during the holy season of Advent, a very holy time in our church. A time of hope, a season of waiting, a season of expectation, to hear God's words of comfort, words of hope, in the face of what we are now all experiencing. And God's holy word, during these days of Advent, especially provides us with the comfort and the hope that we need. As we bring our brother Peter this morning before this sacred altar, with Peter worship week after week, in good times and in bad. And the best thing that any of us can do for Peter today, while we're sitting here in quiet, is to pray for Peter. That's what he needs from us now. Nothing else. There's nothing else you can give him. All we can do now is to pray for him and to commend him into the hands of his Creator, whom we love very, very much. And to the world, to those who have no faith, and unfortunately there are many today, death appears to be the end. But this appears to be the final chapter of a person's life. That's false. Please do not buy into that false secular teaching, because it will get you absolutely nowhere in a very, very hurry. But as Christians, we believe that death is not the end. That this is not just a time to come and bid a fond adieu to Peter Duffy. And let's know what Peter would want this morning. Peter would want us to pray for him, to remember him, will be altar. St. Paul, the great apostle and preacher to the Gentiles, tells us that death is not the end of everything. Rather, it's just the beginning of everything. It's a change. It's a transfiguration from what is weak, what is breakable, to what is strong and indestructible. And we know that Peter has had his share of difficulties in life, and certainly his share of sickness. And many, many times he would go to the hospital. Many times he had close calls. 2 days later, after he had a hospital, where would Peter be back at? At the shop. Who is Peter? What are you doing here? Why aren't you taking care of yourself? Well, people depend on me. I need to be here. Well, we need to be here now for him. That's what we owe him. And so for Peter, and for indeed all those who die believing in Jesus Christ, death is the deepening of that life, which began with Peter on the day that his parents brought him to a small country church where he will be buried in the spring, and asked the priest to baptize him, to welcome him into God's holy people, to allow him to become a member of the Holy Catholic Church. And so we come here this morning not to tell the end of Peter's life. We come here for one purpose, and that is to proclaim our faith in Jesus Christ, risen from the dead. And this faith, which was so deeply rooted in the very soul of Peter Duffy, tells us that everyone who dies believing in Jesus Christ will break through the confines of death into a life that will be unburdened with time and sickness and pain and worries and tears. We all have to go through this moment. I guarantee it. That's one thing you can rest assured this morning. You and I will be in the same place where Peter Duffy is. One day, there's no avoiding it. Trust me. And when we all go through this physical reality called death, then we will enter into a new dimension and new things in our relationship with God. Whether we acknowledge Him or not, He exists, and you will come face to face with Him, whether you want to or not. And when death occurs, no matter at what age, no matter under in what circumstances, there is sorrow, there's grief, and there's sadness, and that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. That's human, and that is natural. But do not grieve as people who have no hope. Peter Duffy was a man of hope, a man of faith. And we believe that Peter is now freed from the confines of this earthly life. So today we commend his soul to Almighty God. judge of the living and the dead. We pray for Peter, that God, who is rich in mercy and compassion, will forgive Peter his sins and count him among his chosen ones. We pray also for ourselves this morning. God, may give us the strength and grace to continue living our lives faithfully, because that's what Peter would want. Until that great day when we shall all meet again.